Hey guys, Nathan here. Mom's Kirk here today to bring you a domination on the map Uplink, or domination on Summit, however you want to say it. Anyways, today we'll be using the MP7 suppressed with fast mag and that nice gold camo and the emblem, yeah, Raven from Teen Titans. But anyways, today we're gonna be talking about two things. One, this is gonna be a map review of the map Uplink, and also I'm starting school next week. Some information and some things I need to tell you before my school year starts, and how my uploading schedule is going to be affected by school. It's pretty important stuff if you want to, you know, if you watch my videos and stuff, so you guys don't wonder, oh, has he disappeared or something? Yeah. So anyways, sit back, relax, hope you enjoy, and let's get started. Anyways, Uplink, we know, is a map that is remade. That's a remake of Summit, which was in Black Ops 1. The only primary difference I've noticed on this map is, well, obviously the layout is completely new. You have it's more of a factory setup. Like, it's more like drone, you know, with the buildings look like factories. And it was kind of hard to adjust to this because I was used to seeing it all snowy and stuff and not green or anything. But after a while you get used to it, and the spawns in this map, it depends. If you know the Black Ops 1 spawns, you're going to love this map. As you see right here, if you watched my radar, they spawn, if you're spawn trapping them on A, they spawn on the back left side of there, and they never stop spawning there. If you are spawn trapping on C, they spawn in the back area with all the grass and stuff. It's copy and paste Black Ops 1 spawns. I have no problem with these, since I usually have good teammates. I was playing with really good people in this party. It was a really, really, really good party. And they were getting VSATs, UAVs, they're helping out. I run, usually my primary rule, see here, there's spawn trapping right here. But my primary rule when I have a party, I hate to feel bossy, but I require people to run at least a UAV, a VSAT, or a counter UAV to support the team. Because if you think about it, you're also supporting yourself, because people get kills while your UAV's in the air, and it gives you UAV assists, and that eventually builds up to your next kill streak. Ones like the VSAT, the orbital VSAT is pretty much an instant load star if you get the VSAT. You just hit the radar whore. I know it's a bad thing to radar whore. I do it all the time, honestly. But once you get that VSAT, everything is so easy. If you die after getting the VSAT, you could still probably have enough points to rack up another VSAT, and then eventually get your Lodestar, VTOL, Swarm, K9 unit, whatever you're running there. But yeah, that's my point. When I usually run in parties, I usually require them to run one team supporting killstreak, and that's when we get good games like this. Everybody went positive, everybody had a fun time. So yeah, back to the map review. This map, another difference is if you're trying to go for those across the map tomahawks, I know a lot of people do this for YouTube, but I did it back in the Black Ops 1 days. And I still do it when I'm playing on the PS3. You're going to have to aim a little higher now. And if you guys, for all you Tomahawkers out there, you know what I'm talking about, across the map spots in these maps. If you're on this side right now where I am, you have to toss it between the two. In Black Ops 1, there was two generators up there. I was staring at my Hellstorm missile, but anyways. There's two generators up in that building. You toss the Tomahawk right between them, and you usually get across the map, right? Well, on this map, the tomahawks, or throwing knives, or whatever they're called in this game, hatchets, when you throw them, they have more gravity on them, so they curve more. Like, you know, they go down faster. So you have to aim a little higher, and you also have to run while throwing them. It's kind of hard to explain. Same with the other side. If you're on the other side throwing across map tomahawks, you're going to have to do the same thing, because the physics involved with the combat axes in this game, I don't know. It's way different than Black Ops 1. So anyways, this map, if I were to rate it out of a 10, I'd rate it out of a 7, a 7 out of 10. The only flaw I find with this map is that sometimes they do spawn behind you, and it's uncontrollable. If you're trying to spawn trap at A, and somebody flips the spawns, you better be watching your back at C, because they're just going to spawn right there. And another thing that really kind of is bothersome on anybody's side is if there's a sniper sniping the right alleyway, you know, with that huge tower you can climb on. Sometimes when you're crossing the corners, some people can shoot you through the wall or shoot you around corners because, you know, the lag compensation. So lag compensation does affect your gameplay And this is spawn trapping, by the way. Hate me for it. I know you guys love me spawn trapping, yeah. But lag compensation is a serious factor in pretty much all the multiplayer games, but this map in particular, because there's lots of corners, there's lots of tight turns. So yeah, this map isn't that bad, and it might, this and Cove, which I'll be doing a Cove gameplay review when I do get a gameplay of Cove, you'll see why I like Cove out of all these. But anyways, enough of the map pack, the map thing. Oh, nice round winning kill, Trixie. But anyways, the next thing we're going to be talking about is school starting. Now, school start does not start this Friday for me. It starts next Friday, but this Thursday I'm going to take me and one of my mates over to the school, and we're going to pick our schedules up and chat and whatever. And I'm kind of excited for the school year. I'm not really, because last year it went really fast, but the people around you, they're terrible. I don't like people around me. I have some of these girls that just, you know, just bother me, and there's some guys too, but, you know, I'm pretty much friends with everybody. There's no point in arguing as people are holding grudges over them, because there's just no point, you know. It's not going to get you anywhere in life. And it's really, I just don't see any point in holding grudges, but beside that fact, anyways, the high school, my freshman year was kind of easy. I maintained a 4.0 GPA almost until, you know, the Odyssey, which is some crappy book in English. That was when my 4.0 GPA fell to like a 3.86 or something. It's still good, but I really am kind of disappointed that I did not get a 4 GPA, but I still got the award for 4.0 GPA at the ceremony, so I'm kind of happy. You know, I'm like, cool, I was close enough, so they counted me as a 4.0 GPA. But beside the point, when school starts, the upload pattern is going to be flipped around. This summer, it's sometimes been one upload a week, sometimes two uploads a week. I've never hit three uploads a week because I need to give time for everybody to watch the current video, right? And when we go back, here's my load star, and on this map, it's absolute hell when you get a load star, and also it runs at a low frame rate, so I might get choppy sometimes. But anyways, great way to see the spawns. But if you remember last year, right before summer starts, I promised to upload more, and I did upload a little more. But if you remember the upload pattern before summer, that's pretty much how it's gonna go this year. Now, here in Oklahoma, sophomore year or freshman year, depending on if you take pre-AP classes or not, is the most important year in your high school time, because you have to take all the important tests your sophomore year, all your EOIs or EOCs or whatever they call them in your area, pretty much like a finals. Yeah, they're finals, yeah. And these are two of the finals I have to take this year. I have to pass in order to graduate high school. In Oklahoma, there's a system that you're allowed to fail like three tests your high school time and still pass. And I'm trying not to fail any of them. I have not failed a final in my life, so yeah. Anyways, final score is 30-4. My upload schedule may be different. It might be like one a week, maybe two a week. But heck, I get a week left of freedom, so I'm probably going to try to make the most out of it. Anyways, guys, hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay/commentary. Please give me a like or a subscribe button if you do enjoy this video, and if you don't, tell me why you don't enjoy it, leave feedback, and recommend, or just leave a topic about me to talk about. See you guys later. Bye.